most of the cases, let's say about 90% or more of the cases of human rights violations happen directly under the orders of Jammeh. We know that, but there might be cases where individual soldiers or security officers take the law into their own hands. Now, when we get the evidence and the evidence implicates him directly in these human rights violations, our recommendations will include, you know, a request for extradition and prosecution of Jammeh. One thing we can all say without any hesitation is that there is the space for people to come out and speak their minds. There is freedom of expression, there is freedom of association, there is freedom of the press, and people are free to come out and express their opinions. They don't have to fear anything. I know that there is still the culture of fear, but that people should overcome that. The fact that some of us are in this country now talking to journalists is very significant. I mean, at some point, if I came here, I would die immediately, right? Thankfully, I didn't come, but people should just know that there is a change. There is a significant change. We have a lot of work to do. The system needs to change dramatically. There is a lot of inefficiency in all sectors of this country. But one thing that is so is that the environment is open now. People can express their opinions. And that would be the beginning of whatever we want to build. You have to have an environment where people can come out and speak. So there are many ways in which Gambians can come forward. And I just encourage everyone to come forward so we get to the bottom of what happened over the past 22 years. We need people to speak up. If you are afraid, we can provide some kind of protection for you. The Ghanaian case is just one of many human rights violations cases that the TRRC is mandated to look at. So there are cases of enforced disappearances. There are cases of extrajudicial killings. There are cases of gender-based violence. And there are cases of land appropriation. There are cases of enforced AIDS treatment by the president. So we have a whole range of human rights violations to look at. The Ghanaian, 44 Ghanaians, one of the people who died was a Gambian. And right now we are in contact with his wife and his family. So that's just one case out of many, many cases. Justice, as far as the victims are concerned, is normally conceived of as prosecuting perpetrators. You know, arresting people who committed human rights violations and, you know, arraigning them before a court of law. That's a very good conception of justice, but it's also a very kind of narrow conception of justice. And, you know, our concern is that you can't just arrest somebody because you know they did a crime. You have to have evidence. So the TRRC process is going to bring out as much evidence as is possible in order to pursue prosecutions. Now, as a commission, we see that only as one part of justice. There is also the justice as right relations, justice as peace, justice as reconciliation. All of those concepts could be seen within the ethic of justice. So we are thinking of justice in more broad terms than just prosecutions, which are also very important and which we are going to recommend in appropriate cases. Most of the cases, let's say about 90% or more of the cases of human rights violations happen directly under the orders of Jammeh. We know that, but there might be cases where individual soldiers or security officers take the law into their own hands and did something that constitutes a violation of human rights. We will still listen to those cases. It doesn't have to be directly linked to Jammeh all the time. We're going to gather evidence, whatever evidence we have, during the duration, the mandate period of the TRRC, which is about 2 years, which is 2 years with the possibility of extension. Now, when we get the evidence and the evidence implicates him directly in these human rights violations, our recommendations will include, you know, a request for extradition and prosecution of Jammeh. So the government is going to take it up with whatever country's government he is at, and then there are international laws. So if that government is a signatory to certain international laws, they would have to comply or they could face sanctions from the international community. But that would be done by the government. Our job is just to gather the evidence to make sure that we have enough evidence to make that recommendation to the government here.